news and weather.
And a good morning to you. Welcome back to First Edition. Outside, we've got cloudy skies and some rain in the area, if you can believe that or not. Take a look at the radar imagery. You know, we really haven't done away with the rain yet. We've been in this persistent pattern that's really stubborn to move out. It's all part of El Nino kind of moving into place, so it's going to make us a little wet for most of this winter, I think. And this is what's shaping up right now. And this is how things have been shaping up. You can see we still have this persistent southwesterly flow. So some more showers moving across parts of the North Shore near Franklinton, Bogalusa, near Folsom, and then back across Tangipahoa Parish. And then maybe a couple of isolated thunderstorms near Baton Rouge, near Zachary, as well as we zoom out south of Lake Pontchartrain, as you can see, and along the Mississippi Gulf Coast. Not seeing a whole lot of rainfall, but over the last 24 hours, here's what we picked up. Over 2 inches in the Baton Rouge area, about a tenth of an inch of rain near Hammond and elsewhere, anywhere from about a half an inch up to as low as 1/100th of an inch. So we'll continue working this through, but on the North Shore, we really don't need more rainfall. The river's having a tough time there, and as a result of the rain that's going to persist, which could be heavy at times, flash flood watch does remain in effect, as you can see, for most of the viewing area, South Mississippi not included, and the lower portions of those parishes south of Lake Pontchartrain, also Jefferson, Plaquemines, and St. Bernard Parish not included. All else, other places, flash flood watch till this afternoon. Temperatures, by and large, kind of cool, mid-40s to right around 50 on the North Shore. South of the lake, we've got 50s. And as you take a look at the 24-hour temperature change, we're running anywhere from 7 degrees up to 23 degrees cooler this morning compared to yesterday morning. So cold air has definitely filtered in. A little bit of fog probably in Hammond with visibility there down to 3 miles. Same thing in Boothville, visibility down to 3 miles. Winds, though, at the surface, pretty much offshore and running about 10 miles per hour. But you can see all the cold air that has filtered in. We've got 50s and 60s on the east side of the front, back side of the front. We've got zero in Salt Lake City, 30 in Dallas, 50 right around our neck of the woods. Satellite and radar imagery showing you what's going on. We've got the stationary front that's hung up across the area that's really not going to go anywhere. So as a result, rain is going to stay in the forecast. Big, big trough. I mean, what we call a big long wave trough encompassing most of the country. And we're going to keep in this flow, and that's going to keep sending these impulses our way. And as you can see, not a whole lot's going to change. We'll keep with a few scattered showers right through this morning into the afternoon, overnight tonight, and then into tomorrow. And then this stationary front will slowly start to shift. But notice tomorrow, still keeping some scattered showers in the forecast, and that's how today is going to be shaping up. Going to stay rather cool on the North Shore, upper 40s, lower 50s. South of the lake, I think mid-50s to lower 60s. We're going to put your rain chances at about 40%. It'll be that on-again, off-again type of rain. And then 40s overnight tonight with a 30% chance of rain wherever it's not breezy and raining. A few areas of fog. Take a look at your 7-day exactcast. Going to keep it cool. Rain's going to stay in the forecast. We're finally going to get rid of the rain, I think, as we hit Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Until then, cool, breezy, and rainy. Keep that umbrella handy. All right, there's your First Edition look at weather. Randy, back to you.
All right, thank you, Jay. You know, if